Have you ever looked at a world map? Of course you have. Everyone has. But here's something that might have escaped your notice. Doesn't Greenland look enormous? Like twice the size of Australia, 1.5 times the size of South America, and even bigger than Africa. In reality, though, Greenland's area is just 2.17 million square kilometers, 3.5 times smaller than Australia, 8.2 times smaller than South America, and nearly 14 times smaller than Africa. So this is what Greenland actually looks like, not this exaggerated version we see on maps. Why does this happen? Does this mean all world maps are wrong? Short answer, yes. But it's not just the map you're looking at that's wrong. Every single world map you've ever seen is wrong, at least to some degree. The reason is simple. You can't flatten the surface of a sphere onto a plane without causing some distortion. This fact was proven by German mathematician Carl Friedrich Gauss in 1827 through his Theorema Egregium. The extent and nature of this distortion depend on the type of map projection used. A map projection is a method for flattening Earth's curved surface to create a map. The most famous projection is the Mercator projection, created in 1569 by Flemish cartographer Gerardus Mercator. It works by wrapping a cylinder around the Earth and projecting every point on the globe onto the surface of this cylinder. Once the cylinder is unwrapped, you get a rectangular world map. The Mercator projection preserves angles, directions, and the shapes of small objects, making it perfect for navigation, especially for sailors. On a Mercator map, a straight line between two points creates a precise angle relative to a compass. Sailors just need to steer their ships to keep that angle constant. And guess what? Mercator's projection isn't just a relic of the past. Google Maps uses it too. Its ability to preserve angles and directions makes city maps incredibly accurate. If two roads intersect at a 90-degree angle on a Mercator map, they will in real life too. But here's the catch. The Mercator projection greatly exaggerates the size of objects farther from the equator. The farther an object is from the equator, the more distorted its size becomes. Check out this video for a comparison of how objects on a Mercator map differ from their actual sizes. It's pretty shocking, right? This is why the Mercator projection has faced heavy criticism throughout the 20th century, especially in schools across the US and other countries. Other projections, like sinusoidal and Gall-Peters, preserve land area, but distort the shapes and proportions of continents. Meanwhile, modern projections like Winkeltrapel, 1921, and Robinson, 1963, aim for a compromise between preserving land area and minimizing distortion. These projections are widely used in atlases and by organizations like the National Geographic Society. Theoretically, you could project Earth onto countless shapes to create different map projections. But here's the thing, every projection will distort Earth's surface in some way. Depending on the purpose, some distortions are acceptable, while others aren't. For instance, the Mercator projection sacrifices accurate relative size to preserve angles and directions, essential for navigation. Meanwhile, area-preserving maps sacrifice angles and shapes. The next time you look at a world map, remember to take it with a grain of salt. Every map is a tool designed for a specific purpose, and each comes with its trade-offs. If you want absolute accuracy, why not invest in a globe? It's the only representation that truly captures the Earth's proportions. After all, the Earth isn't flat, so why should your perspective be? Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more fascinating insights. See you in the next video.